Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Magnidox here for another episode of Dark Souls. And in this episode, we're back in this nightmare of a world where I have no idea what I'm supposed to do. And I feel like that word thing could help me out a whole lot. It might tell me exactly what to do, exactly where to go, and exactly how to do it. But it's just out of my reach, and it's really frustrating. And I don't even think I can get on top of this. Oh, okay, I aggroed him by accident. Oh, wow. Ouch. Okay, that wasn't so good. Gimme. How am I supposed to kill this guy? How much health does he have? I can't even see. These angles are terrible. Oh, they just... I forgot that those are light-seeking, heat-seeking missiles. Maybe I'm hitting it. I don't even kill me up here. How am I supposed to... What am I? How am I? I don't understand. Like, the amount of understanding is zero. Huh. What if I just run away? Maybe we'll give up. What the heck? The freaking sniper! Oh, now it's shooting something else! I'm gonna go fight the other moths. I'm still lost. I am still so lost. I'm gonna try something. Considering I'm so lost, I'm going to completely... And I think y'all have probably noticed from the last episode where I lost about 24,000 souls, and I didn't even... I was kind of upset just by the way I died, but I didn't really care that much, because at this point, I'm pretty sure I've wasted so much time in the lower levels trying to figure out what I'm doing, that I'm pretty much over-leveled for this specific area. Because honestly, what stops me most of the time is not hard boss fights, or just, you know, being killed too easily or not having enough health. I can only think of a few times, like when I was fighting these crystal guys, where the lack of skill was what was keeping me. Or not even the lack of skill, but the lack of health and whatnot, and damage done. I really think that I'm kind of over-leveled for this area. And the only thing holding me back is a lack of knowledge and skill. Not necessarily in that order. So my master plan to figure out what on earth is going on here is to go back to where Seath the Scaleless is and see if I can fight him again. And if I can, see if he's just going to wreck me immediately. Oh. There's a dude back there. Guess I'll have to try again. And I'll see you guys in the next life. Is this a giant window? That looks very suspicious. I'll check that out later. Just because I don't like the looks of it. I have to fight a crystal dude. I might as well heal up. I have plenty of Estus flasks. Hopefully this guy can drop a crystal shield. Or is he a one-time fight only? I'm not going to see my friend again? Who shares my love of crystals? I mean, if there's two things I love, it's crystals and home decorating. And this guy... He has both of my niches taken care of, even though I'm pretty sure he's permanently dead since I killed him that one time. Okay, are you gonna Uber wreck me with no chance of escape? See, I don't see anything that could be of use. Fight me. I'm not dead. Now I'm dead. Yeah, there's no way. Okay, so I cannot fight Seath just yet. He's too powerful. There has to be something I can do to make him not kill me. The question is, what? And I'm back here, and I can't use that bonfire to warp. God dang it, because it's not connected to the warpy-warpy thing, because somehow the ancient electricians forgot to wire it up right or something. So now I gotta climb all the way up here with these snake guys chasing me back to my first bonfire. And I made it! Ouch! I guess I'll rest again, but I still have no idea what to do. Put that pyromancer flame. And go back to the crystal cave! Because that is the only new and interesting thing around here. And I, even with all that, I still have no idea what I'm supposed to do. It's very, very frustrating. Very frustrating. Why? Why? It always seems like at the beginning, when I first go to do something or go to an area, I do decently well and I get about, you know, get a pretty good distance in, and then I get killed. And then, suddenly, when I've gone through that area 5 times before, I suddenly am terrible. And I can't kill 2 crystal dudes. Pretty sure they have named this the Dark Souls effect, when you try to do something that you've done 1,000 times before and you're just terrible at it for some unknown reason. It's the Dark Souls effect. DS effect for sure, for short. DSE. If you suffer from DSE, I mean, there's nothing you can do about it. It's uncurable. Got a blue titanite chunk. Again, I can't do anything with those quite yet. They're pretty much useless. For all intents and purposes of my current character, blue titanite chunks are useless. If you could drop, oh, I don't know, humanities? That'd be great. That'd actually have a use for killing them, besides it's continuing on in the game. Ooh, good thing that staggered him. No, 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 no. Thank goodness. I thought that was going to be me. I was halfway through the crystal. I was dangling off the edge. There was no way. I thought there was no way I would survive that. But I did somehow. I think I've learned from it. I feel like I've grown. I still don't know how I'm supposed to get that item over there. You know what? This is the time where you just start doing stupid stuff just to see what's gonna happen. Whoa. 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 Wait, is this? Oh, that's what it's an invisible crystal. It's a crystal that's so something about it, you can't see it. It's so fine. Oh crap. It's so whatever, you know, Dark Souls logic, whatever, something about a crystal, but it's so perfect that you can't see it. So the path doesn't fall down. Those words aren't floating. It's a pathway. It's been a pathway all along. Oh man, if you could have put that like 5 steps back, that would have been so much more helpful. But oh my goodness. But also, this seems just like the point in Dark Souls where they have a path that twists and turns so much. Oh, there's four blood spots over there. That's never a good sign. Oh, I'm safe. I'm at the other side and I'm safe. That's terrifying. You seem different. You see, I'm only doing 61 damage. I'm pretty sure I normally do 65. You're a very different golem, aren't you? Different crystal giant. He seems like a more muscular one, more buff. He's got more things going for him. What? You choose? Or does stuff fall? Is it you choose where your crystals appear, or is stuff supposed to fall in a certain area when that happens? Uh-oh. Oh, he's too big. He's too swole. Can't even hit me, he's so swole. Oh, I'm dead. Oh, I'm so hot. You're gonna attack twice, man. Can't attack twice when you uppercut. Didn't think about that one, did you? Can't attack twice? No. I'll take my chance, though. Oh, these angles are gonna get me to fall off the cliff. Hey! Yeah, it was different. Even 25,000 souls. Or 2,500, I mean. Okay, so now I have to look for these invisible paths until I die. Until I fall to my death and die. Okay, here's one. Yes. Oh! I was about to be so upset. Imminent fall. Oh, thanks for that. Can I fall on top of him? No, I can't fall on top of him. So that word, that message is left by someone else. Thanks, man. Ouch. Is there two? Oh! Oh my gosh, that side... Really? That side of the crystal is too slanted and you fall if you go on that side? Gosh. Oh, this new area is great. I wasted a whole video trying to kill a moth when really it was just an invisible pathway. You know, because why not? That's just how this game works. I hope that big golem stays dead so I can just kind of move on. I kicked him. I really wish that there was some system in this game that if you killed one enemy enough times, that it just stayed dead. You know, like the pigs. Those were a one-time kill. Why do I have to kill these guys every time I come through here, huh? Why not, you know, 10 and done? When I saw those words just floating on nothingness, I immediately thought it was like, oh, you have to do something, then something falls down for you to walk on, and that's why those guys put those words over there. I never thought invisible pathway. It would be just like Dark Souls. I think the reason Dark Souls is so hard is because it's so... how should I say this? It's not intuitive. There we go, that's the best way to say it. Because Dark Souls is not intuitive in any way. Being able to beat one guy, like the first people, the armored soldier guys, if you learned how to kill them, knowing how to kill them would not help you with the crystal people because they're so different in their moves and the amount of health they have and all of those small things. And in no area before the crystal place were there invisible pathways. So there's no way for you to take a guess besides the snowflakes falling onto the ground. which I didn't even notice. I saw them falling, but I didn't take into consideration that they even that they hit something. The reason I found out they were invisible pathways was just a fluke. I was just trying to see what would happen if I went into that small hole. See if I'd fall to my death or not, and I didn't. I walked on air like I was magic. And then everything became clear. But that is my theory on why Dark Souls, or part of the reason why Dark Souls, is so difficult. It's very hard in each individual, if we look at each area individually, yes, you can learn from your mistakes. But through the overall game, it's very, in the course of the entire game, it is very easy to make the same mistake hundreds of times over. And it is also very hard. And there's also a few mistakes. There's also quite a few mistakes that if you learn from them in the first level, it will bite you and like later on, like opening chests for one reason. Oh, yes, he stays dead. Thank God. Like the chests, the mimics. Yes, some chests will reward you for opening them, and then counterintuitive. Yeah, some chests will kill you for trying to open them. I guess that's the whole point, isn't it? The whole point of difficulty. So I have to stay on the left side. If I go to the right side, I will slip off and die. This is a very close quarters fight. That's it. Back up. Give me room. Oh no. Oh, please don't fall. Thank you. Thank you. Attack. So I can get my stuff back up. Thank you. Okay, zoom. Whoa. Easy there, fella. Gosh, these guys take so long to kill. Nope. Don't go over that side. Oh my gosh. Oh. As long as I have the low ground, he can't punch me with his second hook. I'm too short. I'm gonna back right off the cliff. Okay, whoa. What? I didn't even hit me. I had my shield up. I had my shield up and he still hit me. Now I gotta make my way all the way back. The entire... At least that one guy stays dead. I just have to kill him once. Saving grace. I just had to kill the big guys once. Are those guys still chasing me? Two of them are, but the others aren't. So maybe they'll quit once I get far enough down. You'll never take me alive. And they don't know about the secrets. And they still have no idea what's going on. Whee! It's a little bit of damage for a good cause. Are they still giving chase? Yes. You guys are persistent. I'm interested in just how long they'll go until they give up. I think they gave up. So I can just sprint past those guys. It's just a lot faster. I'll lose some souls, and I won't get, I won't get as many souls as I would if I... Oh, I thought I was gonna die. Because you never know where the edge of this thing is. Now I just have to do the slow process of killing this guy. Why? Ouch, man! Jeez, this guy does a lot of damage. And things like that, like this character, obviously this crystal guy is different. You can tell he's different. But you don't know how different. If you didn't know that he was different, or not, I mean, you know he's different, but if you didn't know how different he was from the other crystal guys in that if he hits you, he takes away most of your health, you wouldn't know just how cautious to be. No, I'm not being cautious at all. I'm just going in there, sort of swinging. I thought you couldn't hit me if I was on the lower ground. Don't kill me. I apologize. Ooh, those uppercuts. Those uppercuts can pretty much instantly kill. I still don't know what that does. I just hear things and I get scared. Don't go over the edge. Yes! Another one down. Now, where's the next pathway? Oh, it's up here. This is so... This is absolutely terrifying. This is the first one that didn't have, like, names or, that didn't have people writing on it. Okay, it looks like it was straight up there. Is that how I got... That's how I got down here. There's no way that's the way it's supposed to go. It has to be, take a turn somewhere. I am on the edge... Looks like it goes all the way up there. I'm gonna go for it. Oh, I'm gonna go for it. Oh, this is terrifying. Oh, I can't see what's... Oh, gosh. This is stressful. I've never seen anything accomplish stress in a better way. Oh, my gosh. I'm gonna make it. Oh, I made it. I'm back up here. Whatever that means for me. So, I got back... Oh, wait. Wait, so I could have... I could have gone down there the entire time? Well, what's over here? There's a path. There's a path there. Yes. Ooh. The little mini heart attack. There's no twists and turns, is it? It's just straight? Looks like it's just a straight path. Here. Okay, what's here? Looks like I gotta go this way. Go, he tried to warn me, I think. Yeah, that was nothing. That was definitely a warning, and I just didn't heed it. At first I thought he meant that there was a turn there, that you're supposed to try not to fall off. I'm sure there is. I'm sure there's some way to get to that item across the way, but I don't know. And I'm not good enough to find out on my own, so I'm just gonna have to go trial and error style. Keep dying until I get it. But I'll have to do that next time, because we are all out of time for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hit the like button if you liked the video, subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll see you guys... next time.